Morning guys, Ben here from 100NMAM. And I've been saying for a while now that on the 50th day, I'm gonna start doing some tests. So here's the first test. It is a urine sample utilizing the Siemens Multistix 10 SGs. I test a number of different things, but for the sake of this test, I'm gonna be testing predominantly the specific gravity, which is here, and the ketones, which is here. Everything else seems to be in good working order. I've already had a quick sneaky look. So what you do is you get a sample pot, you pee in the sample pot midway through your flow, you dip in this stick, and then after a certain period of time, so for example blood here, after 60 seconds you check against the blood section. So I'm just going to go through, basically I've put a link in the description below which outlines what each of these mean. You can interpret them how you wish, but for the sake of these videos I'm going to be testing predominantly my specific gravity, which is the SG, and which is here, and the ketones, which is here. The ketones basically is whether I'm using fat or starving myself, which I don't want to do. I'm not really a subscriber to fasted trainings or fasting, to be honest. And then specific gravity, this basically means how hydrated I am here. Of course, there's so many different factors to consider, how your liver's working. If your liver's not utilizing, it could mean that although you're hydrated, it's not functioning correctly. But there's so many different ways of interpreting this. As I said, I'm not a medical doctor. I'm just going with the basics and from what I've researched. So if we go through, you can see after a period of time, everything gets picked up. So glucose is good. My ketone, which is here, I think it's probably best suited to this one. So that's come back negative. So everything seems to be working there. My urine probably is around about here, so 1.010. There's no blood in my urine. My pH is better. I did a test the other day, my pH levels were relatively high, so it's much better now. There's no protein in my urine, so there's the pH. There's no protein in my urine, which is good. And I don't have any urinary infections, which is also very good. So that's it. There is, as I said, a more detailed breakdown in the introduction link, which is shown below in the description. But for the sake of today, as I said, I'm only measuring predominantly how hydrated I am throughout various bits of the day, pre and post training, and also to ensure that my body is not in the ketosis state. So that's it for me. I will catch up with you later with another test, test two of the day.
Morning guys, 49 days to Ironman. Also the 1st of April. So I can officially say that I shall be doing my Ironman next month. Yeah, scary and exciting. It's getting increasingly real by the day. I watched a amateur's view of the Lanzarote Ironman this morning when I woke up. Just to recap what I've let myself in for. So I got a message yesterday on social media, Facebook, a guy asking why I was doing a urinalysis test. I kind of outlined it before, but the sole reason for me doing it over the next 14 days is to find out really what's working for me, what's happening, what and how my body is functioning on the inside. Because the gut is critical. You know, a lot of people say that the body runs based on the gut and the mind. I kind of agree with many aspects of that in the esoteric and the medical world. And you've got to bear in mind as well that I've started to introduce gels, various supportive supplements into my training. And I really want to know how it's affecting me on the inside. And the only real gauge or way of me doing that is having a good 14 day spectrum of how my body is being effective. So yesterday I did a test, just kind of to give it a go. Learn the ropes, and my pH levels were high. Tested them this morning, so day one of the urinalysis testing, or of the documenting, and they were back to normal again. Now, works on obviously kidney function, but also on your lungs as well. And it's just, I find it interesting going that little bit more in depth and knowing how not only exercise is affecting my ability to, or the connection between my gut and exercise, my gut and the food that I'm taking in. Whether my gut actually is in relatively good health, whether I have any infections or anything like that, whether I have, or I'm hydrated, whether I'm at, you know, diabetic. I've never had a diabetes test, but I know, I have the feeling that I haven't had diabetes or I'm not diabetic. So that's the reason why I'm doing it. It's just to see how my training adjust the stats coming back. That's really why. It's more out of personal interest. Also have a, you know, change some things. If something's not working particularly right, then I have the choice to change it based on the fact that I'm gathering data, I'm analysing what's actually happening. Introducing new gels, as I said, new chemicals into my body. I want to know how they're affecting it. I want to know the state of my body as it stands at the moment, whether it is in as good as good a health as I think it is. I don't really want there to be any second guessing, and urine and my blood glucose is going to be a good way to get a rounded idea. It's not going to be the most in-depth scientific study, and it's going to help me understand myself a little bit more. Something that I don't think enough of us do very often. So that's the reason why I'm doing it. Interest more than anything else, if I was to sum it up in one word. The good news is, you know, based on the test that I did yesterday, or just the kind of outline, and my day one today, the stats are, you know, I'm confidently happy that everything is in good working order and my body is supporting me as I've hoped, as intended. I'm still waiting for my blood sugar tester packet to arrive. You know, that's not arrived yet. So that's what I'm doing. Just a quick body scan, everything is feeling good. Bought a new pair of Brooks the other day. They arrived in the post yesterday morning. They're exactly the same as my current Brooks, the GTS 15s. These are probably going to be the pair that I do the Ironman in. So I've got two pairs of these now, and I'm just going to alternate them, get these broken in, but not using excessively. What else is going on? We've got quite a few bits with work happening at the moment, so in the background, so I'm, you know, dipping in and out of that. My body feels relatively good, healthy. There is a little bit, I've got a little pulling pain just in the crutch area. It could be a muscle tear. It's not a tendon. It's definitely in the muscle region. So I'm just keeping an eye on that. Apart from that, everything else is good. You know, the diet staple, still around about the 80 kilos mark. I was going to have a body scan yesterday, one of the ones that I had at the beginning, day one, but I've decided to delay that over the until maybe 2 weeks before, maybe the week before I fly out to Lanzarote, so that I'm not working to the results that it gives. Again, it's very easy to be told something and then you work into that. What I'd rather do right now in the present is just focus on following my plan and sticking to my plan. Don't want to get too caught up on the numbers, although I've just spoken about the urine and the blood. What I don't want to get caught up on is whether the results come back and say that my body fat is higher or I'm dehydrated or anything like that. I want to go off actual fact and internal feelings as opposed to what a machine says. You know I've lost body fat. My abs are pretty defined now. I've lost a lot of my side flat fat where I had it before. Did measure myself the other day. My arms, I've lost an inch and a half in 50 days around my biceps, but I've gained an inch and a half around my calves and nearly 2 inches around my quads. So there's an indication there that obviously something has changed. Haven't lifted a dumbbell now for near on 60 days, which is rare because I was hitting the gym pretty much every day. Anyhow, mindfully, good. You know, everything's going to plan as far as I can see. I'm very, very happy with how things have gone. I'm glad it's recovery week, to be fair. You know, I was starting to tire very quickly during the latter part of the day. Yeah. So that's that. So that, as I said, that's it for today. It's Friday. I've got a run now. It's a 50-minute slow pace. I'm going to head from where I am now at the gym down to the beach, back around and then back here. I'm not going to record it, just on the basis that it's a route that I've done before. It's not that exciting in terms of scenery. So that's it. I will catch up with you later on, probably after the run. And then again later for my second urine test of the day to see how the run and my hydration through the run and after the run has affected the stats from just a moment ago that you saw or in the previous section of the video. So yeah, it'll be interesting to see the difference. And that's one thing that I'm going to be doing with that test specifically, is to see what's happening with my body pre and post workout, especially on the longer rides. I'd had a look and I couldn't actually see it documented on YouTube anywhere, any athletes. A couple of runners have done it, but certainly not specifically targeted at the Ironman where they've done these kinds of things. So it may be a first, or maybe I'm just not looking hard enough. But the stats may come back the same, and it might be a pretty boring addition to my 100 days to Ironman, but could uncover some interesting bits and pieces. So that's it for now. Have a good day. Peace out. So that's the run done. Worked out about 8k in 50 minutes, and just run from where I was down to the beach, along the beach, and then back up again. Nice and easy pace. Just brought really my awareness inwards. Didn't think too much, or avoided where possible thinking about anything, to be honest. I think it's a really nice place to just to get into sometimes. Just cut out what's going on outside. Look at the scenery. As I said this morning, I didn't want to have a body stat done yesterday, because I think it can be easy then to alter the training based on that. But also, I wear a heart rate monitor, I wear, you know, I analyse the data, but I'm also conscious of not becoming too much of a stickler, focusing all of my effort on the numbers when you have beauty effectively around you in all the places. Now, I'm fortunate where I live and the areas that I can go to, I'm blessed with the countryside and the beach. It's both on my doorstep, and I appreciate that may not be the choice for everyone, but I'm a great believer you can find beauty in some of the darkest, dirtiest places. Again, the temptation when running is to look down, focus on positioning, focusing on the next 5-10 yards, and often you can miss, you know, the peripheral, what's going on, the beauty. So today I really focus, especially when I hit the beach, about looking beyond and on the horizon, obviously still keeping awareness to the foot and where I'm running, but also to look beyond and appreciate a bit of nature, not becoming immersed within the numbers, the stats, the heart rate zones. So that's it for now. I will catch up with you later on.
Right, so I've just received my blood glucose monitoring system, and this is the first attempt at measuring my blood glucose levels. So here we go. I've read the instructions. I'm going to follow it as per the recommended guidelines. So, okay, so there's the results from the second attempt. When I pricked it with my finger the first time around, not enough blood came out, as you can see here in the top of the screen. But the second attempt drew the right amount of blood. And there it is. There's the results. So what I'm going to do, this is pre-food. I'm going to do it again tomorrow pre-food and just keep an eye and analyse all of the data. But I'll be talking about the data and what these numbers mean in more detail later on. So here's test two of the day. And as you can see, all of my levels are pretty much where they should be. All on the negatives or on the lower sides. My hydration levels are mid again. I could probably do with a little bit more hydration, to be fair. I was aware of that just by the colour of my urine, but I'm happy with all of the other results. Everything is negative or where it should be. So again, it's just been interesting today, just keeping an eye on the hydration levels and seeing how it's affected. The pH adjusted from yesterday slightly in the positive, so there's been shifts within my body. And I did a blood test today, which you'll see in this video, or if you're watching this as part of the playlist on my urine, then why not take a look over at the other playlists that I've got available where I'm testing other bits and pieces of my body. But that's it for now. So that's the end of the day today. It's Friday, so I'm just about to finish up my last bits and pieces, submit a couple of videos. I did my blood glucose test earlier on, so you can check that out. I'll put a link in the description below. It took me 2 attempts to prick my finger. I put it on a lesser setting and didn't
was unable to get enough blood, so I had to do it again. But it came out as expected at 5.5, which is at the higher end of the normal level. And I've got to make some adjustments because I'm consuming food every 2 to 3 hours and refueling. I think it's going to be at that kind of 5-ish level, as stable as I can, or keeping it at that 5-ish level as stable as I can throughout the day. But time will tell. And again, there's room for more learning and education from me in that respect. So that's it from me. Tomorrow I've got a ride, so I will see you pre-ride in the morning, and have a good evening. Thank you again for all of your kind words and comments, and hope you have a good evening or weekend if I don't catch up with you beforehand. But for now, it's that time. Peace out.